Shalom, shalom, dear listeners of Kanguka. My name is Chris Ndikumana, and I am the host of the Kanguka broadcast. Today is Wednesday, and I want to share a word on how to spiritually prepare your day. I'm going to share from Ephesians chapter 6. I know that many of you are familiar with the chapter which talks about the whole armor of God. I love verse 11 on chapter 6 that says, "Put on the whole armor of God." That's right. The same way you put on clothes every morning, you need to clothe yourself with the armor of God. All the warfare equipment that's listed further down in this chapter is based on what Roman soldiers used to wear. You might have seen what it looks like on some pictures or in movies about that era. When you look at a Roman soldier in his full gear, you have to understand that he had to put on every piece one at the time. He put on his sandals, his helmet, his belt, his breastplate. He carried his sword and shield. He clothed himself with the full warfare equipment. Today I want to put an emphasis on verse 11, which says, "Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil." You've got to understand that Satan is always scheming and setting traps for the believers. If you are not fully clothed with the armor of God, you can't stand against Satan. From verse 14 to verse 17, you can read the list of all the spiritual weapons that make up the whole armor of God. Every child of God should put on the full armor of God. Why is it necessary? Take a look at verse 12. It says that we don't wrestle against flesh and blood. Let me tell you that we are at war. Yes, we are in a fight. Every child of God, every believer is in a fight. Our opponents or enemies fall into three categories. There are principalities, powers, and the rulers of the darkness of this age. I want you to know that there are evil spirits in the air that seek to destroy you. That's why it's crucial that children of God put on the armor of God. So when you wake up in the morning, you need to put on the armor of God in order to spiritually prepare your day. I want to focus on one spiritual weapon that you need to put on every morning. It's found in verse 14. It's the belt of truth. The belt of the Roman soldier used to keep the other equipment in place. For example, the sword was attached to it. We see in verse 14 that the belt is a picture of truth. Let me be clear, dear listeners of Kanguka. If you want to be victorious against Satan, you absolutely need to walk in truth. Many Christians easily lie. Their lives are full of lies. You need to know that every time you lie, you're opening the door to Satan, and he will use it to enter into your life. If you want to be victorious against Satan, you need to put on truth every morning and ask God to enable you to walk in truth all day long. Another spiritual weapon listed in verse 14 is the breastplate of righteousness. The breastplate protects the chest, and it's a picture of righteousness. Nowadays, many Christians don't want to hear about righteousness. They just want to do whatever pleases them. Their lives are filled with lies, fornication, masturbation, and all sorts of other bad things, yet they still want victory. Let me tell you that you can't experience victory when you are living in sin. This is important when it comes to preparing your day spiritually. Preparing your day isn't just saying, "God, I put the day in your hands," or "I close the doors to Satan." It's more than that. Preparing your day is putting on the armor of God, is putting on truth and righteousness. You have to ask God to give you the grace that will enable you to walk in truth so you can avoid lies. It's good that you do this in the morning. Many people are caught in Satan's traps because they didn't put on truth in the morning. They didn't put on righteousness when they woke up. You need to put them on every morning, and you also need to tell God that you want to walk according to his word all day long. It's only then that you will receive victory. Trusting that God will fight for you is a good thing, but it's not enough. You have to walk in truth. You have to repent of your sins and walk in the light. It's only then that I am will manifest his presence and fight for you all day long, because you spiritually prepared your day. We are continuing our teaching on sanctification. This teaching started on Monday. I was telling you yesterday that Jesus isn't impressed by our outer appearance. In some churches, if you dress well, especially for women, if they cover up and are modest, meaning your clothes are not too revealing and you have good manners, you are considered a holy person. This is because people's judgment is superficial. We judge people's walk with God by the way they dress, the way they talk. Jesus is teaching us that God doesn't look at the outside, but He looks at our hearts. That's because sanctification starts in our heart before it becomes evident in the outside as well. The outcome of our internal sanctification will be evident in our walk. Most people worry more about their outer appearance. They worry about how they are perceived by others instead of caring about the state of their hearts. It's true that your external appearance should also be a reflection of God's glory. But I'm trying to teach you that you need to work on cleansing your heart first, and as a result, your life will change. The way you address people will change. The way you carry yourself will change. What you say or how you dress, that's all gonna change. Your friendship will be affected. The purification of your heart will have an impact in every area of your life. Yesterday, we were talking about Matthew chapter 23, verse 28, which says, "You appear to people as righteous. In the eyes of men, you look righteous. People admire you. They think that you're spiritual because you appear to them as such. They don't know that you are full of hypocrisy and iniquity." In verse 27, Jesus was addressing to Pharisees, calling them hypocrites, comparing them to the beautiful whitewashed tombs full of dead men's bones. They are beautiful in the outside, but rotten in the inside. God's interested in the condition of our hearts. The purpose of this teaching is to allow us to examine our hearts. When convicted by the Holy Spirit, let's repent so that we can achieve our sanctification. Only then will our walk with God be better. If you want our prayer life to be impacted, if you want to experience the presence of God, if you want to go to the mountain of God, we need to be sanctified. We might have a lot of obstacles in our walk, but the Word of God can help us achieve a life of sanctification. Today I want to start by explaining the word hypocrite. If you consult the dictionary, you will see that in simple terms, the definition of hypocrisy is to pretend to be what you're not. Hypocrites will show you that they are nice and caring, but in reality, they are bad or unpleasant or mean. They might tell you that they love you, but really full of hate towards you. Jesus explained the word hypocrite differently. In Matthew chapter 6, verse 1, it says, "Take heed that you do not do your charitable deeds before men to be seen by them, otherwise you have no reward from our Father in heaven." In the following verse, Jesus explains that if you do a charitable deed, you shouldn't sound a trumpet in the synagogues or in the streets the way hypocrites do. They do it so people notice them and praise them. Jesus says in the end that the hypocrites have their reward. Seeking people's approval and praise is what Jesus calls hypocrisy. If you want people to like you and approve of you, if you want people to praise you, you're not different than these Pharisees. It means that you're a hypocrite. In verse 5, Jesus calls out those who pray in order to be noticed. He calls them hypocrites. You may ask why. Jesus calls them hypocrites because they pray in the street corners and they won't appear spiritual and they are showing themselves off to people. I urge you to stop it if you do the same. If you are the kind that wants to appear righteous and spiritual in front of man, it means that you have a spirit of hypocrisy. You can't be sanctified if you have this spirit of hypocrisy. I will continue teaching on this tomorrow so that we can be freed of this spirit. May I bless you. Have a wonderful day.